Now then, Richard, what is this you bought in?
This, my streetwise chum, is the reason you should regard Lancia with respect and passion.
The finest Italian cars are often so very expensive, but there is one forgotten beauty that you can pick up for less than a Ferrari exhaust, the Lancia Fulvia.
They're so elegant, so chic, and when they were new, they were terribly expensive. In fact, before Fiat bought Lancia in the early 70s, the company was responsible for some of the greatest and most exclusive cars ever built. With a top speed of only 105 miles an hour and 0 to 60 in just 12 seconds, the little Fulvia was trounced by the macho Jaguar E-Type, which did 150 miles an hour and cost the same money. But that misses the point. The E-Type was just so blatant. To drive one of those was like standing on a street corner with your trousers around your ankles. The Lancia Fulvia, by comparison, was the height of discretion and ultimate good taste. Make no mistake, the Fulvia was no blouse. With its great reliability and superb handling, the car made an excellent rally car. In fact, Lancia secured the 1972 championship with it before going on to win all sorts of other international events too. The model they used to achieve that was called the Fulvia HF. These are fabulous cars, real wolves in sheep's clothing. They're warty, they're throaty, oh, and they really bring out the hooligan in you. The trouble is, at twice the price of a standard car, they're not the obvious choice.
It's much easier to get your hands on a Series 2 Fulvia. They're beautifully designed and engineered and so reliable that you can use them for everyday transport.
In fact, driving this car now is like driving a 10-year-old Golf GTI, not a 25-year-old classic. So, what do you get for your money? Well, at the heart of this Bambino is a V4 front-wheel drive engine, which Lancia very cleverly have laid down on its side. That lowers the centre of gravity, which allows for better handling, and allows for this low, sleek bonnet line as well. It's attached to a 5-speed gearbox, and the car also has 4 disc brakes with servo assistance, and that's a very impressive specification for the early 1970s. Now, all these mechanics are mounted on a subframe under the car that's attached to the floor in 6 places. Now, it's absolutely vital that you check each one of those mountings for rust, and I suggest you start down here because these are the first to go. Now, if you've had subframe problems, the chances are a lot of strain has been put on the bodywork of the car, and a telltale sign of that is a vertical split in the front wing here above the front wheel. And in really bad cases, the sills will have gone as well, and that will affect the way the door opens and closes. Now, Fulvias do rot around their rear ends as well, but all that'll be fairly obvious. What won't be so obvious is around here in the rear corners of the roof. Water collects down here and can make its way inside the car, so have a good look. When you come to start a Fulvia from cold, don't worry if your oil pressure needle flies off the screen, because it's meant to. What's more important is that it resettles when the engine's hot at around the halfway position. If it doesn't, you could be in for a very expensive engine rebuild.
Fine cars though they are, old Lancias deteriorate like any old Italian car. Many of the parts are hard to find, especially the exterior trim. So don't rush your inspection and look at all those beautiful details.
Now, the really good news is that you can buy a perfectly usable Fulvia Series 2 for as little as £2,000 to £3,000. But I suggest you spend more than that and pay £5,000 and buy a really mint one, because that is a snip by anybody's standards.
So thank you very much again for watching. Keep out of trouble and in the money. Until next time, bye-bye.
See ya.
You know what, I really enjoyed that series. It was great, wasn't it?
Well, yes, mate. You lost us a load of money, though.
I never lost you nothing.